Welcome to Imagination Station. I am so glad you're here. I can't wait to see what incredible things about God we'll discover this week. We're going to have so much fun together, but before we get started, I need you to gather a few items. You'll need your decoder disc from today's white supply bag, a cup with a little bit of water in it, and a piece of paper and a pencil. Do you remember what you need? I'll remind you. Your decoder disc, a cup with a little water, a piece of paper, and a pencil. I'll give you a minute to get those things. Now I have something very important to ask you. Something very important. Who brought their imagination today? It's okay if not everyone remembered. It's our first day of VBS. But since we are at Imagination Station, we're definitely going to need lots of imagination. The great news is I have an extra bit of imagination to spread around. In fact, I was just talking to my friend Pogo, the poison dart frog, about this. I think you met him earlier, right? Pogo and his friends love living in the rainforest in Central and South America. The rainforest is full of huge trees and super long vines and so many plants and flowers that you can't see through them all. That's a lot of plants. And a lot of rain. The rain is very important. It keeps everything alive. We're going to bring our imaginations to life now with some imagination drops. I'm going to give you a few seconds to run and get your small cup of water in case you don't already have it. I want you to feel all this imagination running down on you. So dip your fingers into the water and flick it over your head. God knows Pogo and his friends need rain. And God knows you too.
You are treasured!
Now I can see your imaginations are refreshed, alive, and ready to go. Are you ready? Here's our first talk starter question. How do you think poison dart frogs catch the insects and bugs they dine on? Do they use their very sharp teeth? Or do they catch them with their long, sticky tongues and eat them whole? Okay, I need your help in making a loud drum roll before I reveal the answer. Are you helping? And the answer is, a poison dart frog uses its long, sticky tongue to reach out and grab bugs and insects and swallows them whole. Imagine that. All week long, you'll get to answer fun talk starter questions like you just did. This is called a decoder disc. Take a look. It's kind of mysterious. This decoder disc is a super secret way to communicate in code. There have been lots of times people have used code to communicate. People have used codes throughout history to send secret messages. Can you think of a time you used code to communicate? Perhaps with a friend or a brother or a sister? Let's try speaking in code right now. We're going to learn a code called Pig Latin. Make a pig noise if you know how to speak Pig Latin. I don't think I make a very good pig. Here's how you speak it. You take the starting sound of a word and move it to the end and add A to the sound. For instance, let's use the word pig. Pig becomes igpay. Words that start with a vowel stay the same, but you still add the A to the end. So the sentence, I ate the pig, becomes I ate a ive ig pay. Whew, that's kind of hard. I'm going to give you a minute to practice saying your name in pig Latin to someone around you. Just a reminder, my name in pig Latin would be Indice. Speaking in code is kind of tricky. Now think of something you want to tell others, but don't say it out loud. Think of how you'll say it using pig Latin. Think for a minute. What will you say? Will it be something about the weather? About VBS? Turn to someone in your home and tell them your message using pig Latin. How easy or hard was it to speak in pig Latin? Sometimes codes are tricky and mysterious. If you were a treasure hunter, you might have to decipher codes to find treasures. Figuring out codes can help solve mysteries. Now you're going to use your decoder disc, paper, and a pencil to write a code. Let's put our decoder discs together first. With the little thinnest part and the longest green plug, stick your green plug through the thinnest part so it looks like this. Now look closely at the hole in the center of the thicker circle and line up your green peg so it fits into the thicker part. To make sure it stays, you can put the shorter green peg in too. And now you have a decoder disc that will spin for you. First, I want you to write your name in code using your decoder disc. To do that, you find your letter of your first name in the little circle and look at the code beneath it. And then you draw that code on your paper. You'll twist the decoder disc to find the symbol for each letter of your name. And then you'll draw that symbol. Once you have found the symbols for all the letters of your name, you have your name in code. You know, if you think your name is long, or if this is kind of hard, because I think it can be a little tricky, you can just find your initials, the first letter of your first name and the first letter of your last name. I'm going to give you some time to do that. Great work! Now think of a secret message you'd like to write in code and get busy. You might want to make it a little shorter if you thought that was a little trickier to do, a lot longer if you think that was pretty easy to do. I'll give you a few minutes to write your message. Great work on making mysterious messages. Remember, today we're discovering that God knows you.
You are treasured!
You know, sometimes it's easy to feel confused and lost, sort of like a message that's written in code. We might wonder if God really knows what's happening in our lives. We might even feel like life is a confusing mystery and we don't know what's going on. But here's an important truth to remember. God knows you.
You are treasured.
Nothing about you is a mystery to God. God knows what's happening with you. And God is in control and working for your good. God created you and God loves you. I hope you had a great time at Imagination Station today. See you tomorrow.